الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد All conditions are from Allah and Allah is Hakim, most wise. He knows the hikmah and the reason behind every situation and circumstance. Hazrat Wahab bin Munabih rahimahullah used to say وَجَدْتُ فِي التَّوْرَاءَ أَرْبَعَةَ أَسْطُرَ I found in the Torah four lines مَنْ قَرَأَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ لَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ فَهُوَ مِنَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ Whoever makes tilawat of Quran and they don't believe that they will be forgiven and they will benefit from the nur and the tajalli of Allah as if they are mocking Allah مَنْ شَكَى مُصِيبَةً نَزَلَتْ بِهِ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُو رَبَّهُ Any calamity that befalls anybody and they complain, they don't exercise sabr as if they are complaining about Allah. مَنْ هَزِنَ عَلَى مَا فَاتَهُ فَقَدْ سَخَطَ عَلَى قَضَاءِ رَبِّهِ Whoever grieves and is sorrowful of his loss, then as if he is grieving and he is angry and upset with the decision of Allah. وَمَنْ تَوَاضَعَ لِغَنِيٍ ذَهَبَ ثُلُثًا دِينَهُ Whoever honors a affluent person because of his wealth, even though he is way and life is contrary to the awamir and commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then as if he has sold his deen, he has compromised on his yaqeen and akhirat. So when conditions come, we shouldn't complain and know that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the time of Nabi alayhi salam, a sahabi used to come with his child. And one day it happened, this child passed away. So Nabi alayhi salam noticed that the father was not present in his majlis. And he asked Sahaba about it. So they told him, he said, Ya Rasulallah, mata sabiyuhu alladhi ra'aytahu. His son had departed from this world. So Nabi alayhi salam said, Why did you not inform me? Qumu ila akhina. Let's go and visit him. When Nabi alayhi salam entered, إِذَا رَجُلٌ حَزِينٌ وَبِهِ كَأَبَهُ He was very grieved and sorrowful and stressed. So he told the Nabi of Allah, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنِّي كُنْتُ أَرْجُوهُ لِكِبِرْ سِنِّي وَضَعْفِي I was hopeful he will grow up and in my old age he would support me. In my weakness he would assist me. So Nabi alayhi salam said, that don't you prefer that you come on a day of Qiyamah and it will happen that this child will be told أُدُخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ Enter Jannah and this child will say Ya Rabbi Abawai O Allah my parents وَيُقَالُ لَهُ أُدُخُلْ be told enter Jannah three times فَلَا يَزَالُ يَشْفَعُ حَتَّى يَشْفَعُ اللَّهُ He will intercede and continue to ask Allah for intercession until the child gets the parents into Jannah. فَذَهَبَ الْهَزْنُ عَنِ الرَّجُلِ All his grief, worry and anxiety disappeared and dissipated. So any difficulty, whether it is ourselves or our family or our relatives, have hopeful and understand, be hopeful and have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and realize that the value and the opportunity Allah has given one. It is a ni'mat, not a niqmat. Continue with the virtues and the importance of miswak. We find that deen gives particular attention to the outside, external, the body and the internal, the ruh. And all the remedies needed, Allah has integrated it. And that's why as counted previously, 40 to 50 times a day, Nabi alayhi salatu salam would probably be making miswak. If we look at it, the mouth is the main entrance to the most important organs of the body. And that is where there is access to the upper respiratory tract, the lungs, the digestive system, And even more so, the nervous system, which is connected to the teeth, the facial area, and that eventually from the nervous system can affect the brain. So when a person is protecting their mouth and utilizing the miswak, it is not just one-sided, but all the germs that collect and move from the mouth downwards to the respiratory tract, the trachea, going down to the stomach, can cause a lot of infections, cause abscesses. It can even lead to septicemia, blood poisoning, and other sicknesses as well. Even stagnant saliva, which has certain minerals, require movement, and through the utilization of the miswak, thus gradually displaces and removes plaque and strengthens the gum line as well. So, utilizing the miswak, not only for its benefits, but because my Nabi did it, that's why I will use it. No matter what scientists are saying and what diseases that affect the tissues around the teeth, my Nabi did this, that's why I will do it. And if we look at a person who gets gum infection and tooth decay, which can result in the loss of teeth, how will a person make tilawat of Quran? Tajweed, when we study the laws of tajweed, requires certain teeth for certain huruf letters. So even for our tilawat of Quran, it is imperative that we give priority and importance to dental hygiene, and that is the miswak. And for cure and shifa from many sicknesses, prevention is better than cure. So if we are not saying only utilize the miswak, Allah knows best what is better. But just to understand, some researchers did research on 80 people and they divided them into 4 groups. So the first group was going to use the miswak only, secondly the extract of the miswak, which is miswak powder. Third, the normal toothpaste, which is commercially available. And lastly, cornstarch. And the purpose of the study was to see whether the miswak can replace a toothbrush and toothpaste. So externally, it seemed that the toothbrush would be more accurate and more consistent in keeping hygiene in mind, and the miswak, which angular wise and other reasons would not suffice. So the whole experiment was conducted. Then the siwak, the miswak, it was grounded into a fine powder and it was used with a normal toothbrush. So it was, second experiment was to see whether using the miswak or miswak powder, and to see the efficiency in that. And also the chemicals that are extracted from the miswak, how beneficial it is to the teeth. So we find that their results were that because plaque forms and it hardens and it affects the soft and hard tissues, the first group of people who use the miswak occasionally and repeatedly, it was found that they had a very high level of oral hygiene because of the natural substances which Allah has placed from the silica, which makes the teeth and the enamel solid, the fluorine content, which strengthens the gums, the tannin and vitamin A, which strengthens blood vessels, and other components which has been discussed previously. The result of the whole experiment found that those that use the miswak properly, and we have discussed how times, winds, and the size and the trimming, etc. If it is utilized according to the requirements, then those people were the most successful. Then the ground powder siwak, They also found there was an absence of infection when they compared it to the other two groups, and they had an improvement in the results from the other two groups who used normal toothbrushes and cornstarch. So they concluded that priority-wise, if a person used a miswak only, it would suffice. If a person used a normal toothbrush and used, it would be also more beneficial than the other two groups. This is scientific research. Now, whether the research is true or not, whether it makes sense or not, that is immaterial. As a believer, مَنْ تَمَسَّكَ بِسُنَّةِ أَمْنَ فَسَارِ أُمَّتِي فَلَهُ أَجْرُ مِئَةِ شَهِيدٍ. I will get the reward of 100 shaheeds if I shuhada, if I revive one dead sunnah. This is a dead sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. There was a scientist, Roger, who was a head of the Microbiology Institute of Rostock University in Germany. In 1961, he had read about the miswak and about his friends that used to speak about the Arabs cleaning their teeth with a piece of wood in the 20th century. And he was amazed that there were still some people on earth that used pieces of wood. So he had a Sudanese assistant who was a microbiologist, and it so happened that one day he had a miswak, so he gave it to him. So he crushed the miswak, he placed it in wetted powder, and he grounded it, and then he put it in a petri dish. And after whatever experiments, he found it appeared like traces of penicillin. Now we see the benefits of penicillin. So then he was amazed that for the last 100 or 200 years, people have been using toothbrushes and toothpaste. But Nabi alayhi salam has encouraged us 1400 years ago. So we should make it a habit, should make it a routine, understand that this is divine, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even if scientifically they listed no benefits, every time we utilize the miswak, and as mentioned about the fadail of salat, about the virtues of reading salat, the fadail and the virtues of every amal that is done, that is used with the miswak and without the miswak. So it is not just about using the miswak on its own like that, no. But following the requirements and making sure it's freshly cut, making sure that it is not left too long in water so that we remove all the rich active constituents and ingredients, where all the therapeutic properties are lost. And when we utilize it also, like a normal toothbrush, it is cleansed and cleaned. The miswak should be cleansed and cleaned as well. The fibers should be clipped off, so it is in similitude and it resembles a toothbrush, the vertical, horizontal brushing, and the times that we should utilize it as well. Some research was done in Tanzania and Ethiopia, and they found that children that were utilizing the miswak compared to those were not prone to any gum disease or enamel or decay, and it was a very strong preventative measure. So there's a lot of data, and we can go online and study it as well, of what the miswak and the fadail of the miswak is. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq of understanding the value of this amal, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow the sunnah of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The amal for today is من دخل السوق, whoever enters the souk, the bazaar, فقال لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيد الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. And a person recites this dua, then كتب الله له ألف ألف حسنة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write for him 1,000,000 rewards, ومحى عنه ألف ألف سيئة, 1 million sins will be erased. وَرَفَعَ لَهُ أَلْفَ أَلْفِ دَرَجَةٍ 1 million stages elevate. This riwayat is in Tirmizi, Ibn Majah, Hakim. So when a person is going to the supermarket, the mall, etc., and they read this dua, then they are much virtuous. And this other riwayat explained, ذَاكِرُ اللَّهُ فِي الْغَافِلِينَ بِمَنْزَلِتِ الصَّابِرِ فِي الْفَارِينَ. When a person is in a battlefield and all his associates are fleeing, and he's patient and he fights, that's like a person who's dhakirullah, who's making dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while people are negligent. Hazrat Abu Bakr Shibli rahimahullah, it happened such that one day he needed a miswak and he couldn't find it. So in that anxiety he bought one that was closest to him. The person wanted 1 dinar, 1 gold coin. In today's terms, 1 Kruger coin. So onlookers that were there said, you spent so much for 1 piece of stick. How is it possible? So he replied, he said, the world and whatever is in it is not worth the wing of a mosquito in the eyes of Allah. What answer will I give Allah on the day of Qiyamah when he will ask me and inquire, why did you miss the sunnah of my beloved? When you had the wealth and the possessions which I had given you, and that wealth and possessions were not even equivalent to the wing of a mosquito, yet you were stingy to utilize that wealth which was so insignificant for something which was so significant. Why did you not spend it in accomplishing such a great sunnah? So the ulama and the mashayikh of the past did not look at the worldly commodities and see the benefits and harms with regards to the dunya, but they looked towards the benefit of akhirat. There was one businessman who was traveling and he met a new Muslim from Switzerland, and after they were departing, he gave him a miswak as a hajj gift. So this person became very elated and happy, and he started kissing the miswak and put it to his eyes, and tears welled down. So this person was shocked and wondering what had happened. Did I do something wrong? So he inquired. So that person said, no, you haven't done anything wrong. Then he took out from his pocket a miswak which was close to almost being finished. He said, when I embraced Islam, I was given this, and now it is on its last stages. And this is what I have left of it. I kept it as a memory. But at a point in time when I accepted Islam, I had a chronic infection, and there was no cure. There was no cure. And the doctors were trying to see what solution they could come up. And at that time, when I was given the miswak, I started utilizing it proficiently. And when the day came for me to go for my tests again, I went and they did all tests and they noticed that I was cured completely from this infection. So the doctor was shocked and astonished that what had happened. So the only thing that came to my mind at that point in time was that I was using the miswak. So I told him that the cure for my illness was the stick, and I showed him the miswak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand the value of our short life, utilize our time and energies in the correct direction. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all the fitnas. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.